Hi guys, welcome to the M1903 Marksman. Today I will disclose everything that you need to know to dominate the battlefield with this sniper rifle. And I will show you how we can use your minimap to estimate the distance to your next victim. The M1903 is actually the M1903 Springfield, an American gun that was primarily used during the first half of the 20th century. It was used in World War I, later it was replaced by the M1 Garand, but there weren't enough of those around for World War II, so the M1903 remained in service. Even today, it is still being used by various military drill teams. If you prefer to make long-range sniper kills, then you're going to love this gun, so let's start with the statistics. One bullet can cause 80 damage. After 80 meters, this damage will go up, and at 100 meters, you will be able to make a one-shot kill. This is the start of your sweet spot, and it ends at 150 meters. After 150 meters, the damage will drop again, and it will settle back at 80. This is Battlefield's one and only ultra long-range sniper rifle. It has the furthest sweet spot of all sniper rifles in Battlefield 1. The only other gun that even comes close is the Guerrier 98, but that sweet spot already ends at 125 meters. All the other guns don't even make it past 100. Not that it would matter to a headshot king like yourself, but you will need 2 bullets to kill outside of the sweet spot. The rate of fire is 51 rounds per minute, so for you that are 51 headshots per minute. Time to kill is 1.135 seconds, and at 100 meters, it will become slightly more than 1.255 seconds. That time to kill is outside of the sweet spot range, and I'm sure that you know what's going to happen within that range. Time to kill is not even worth mentioning. Just aim, shoot, and gone will be your enemy. See you in the next life. The Guerrier 98 has the highest muzzle velocity of all sniper rifles in Battlefield 1. The M1903 is slightly slower, but not much. 820 meters per second compared to 880 meters per second. That is still fast enough so that you won't have any significant difficulties with leading your targets. No surprises for the bullet drop, 12 meters per second squared. When you deploy on the battlefield, you will start off with 5 bullets in your magazine and you will have 25 more for later. As you can see, this gun can be used for close range combat. But ideally, you should adjust your strategy so that you can increase the distance between yourself and your target. There are only a few ways to tell the distance to your target unless you know the maps by heart. You can use the flags as your reference, but your enemy isn't going to hug that pole until you make your shot. We're not in a strip club here. So you will have to use something else. First of all, make your minimap a little bit less mini, because nobody can use it at this point. So open up your settings and go to gameplay. Scroll all the way down and change the minimap size to 140%. Right above that, you will see the on-foot zoom radius. Change that to 200. And now you are ready to make those long-range kills. So what has changed? First of all, your minimap is now usable. And on top of that, we just changed the range of that thing so that it can help you to get a much better idea of the distance between your enemy and the bullet that has his name on it. The standard range of your map is now 200. When you press N or November, you will change the range. Basically, you will change the zoom of the minimap. If you press once, you will change it to 400. Press again for 100, and another press will set it back to 200. Leave it at 200, because this is perfect for sniping. If you really have to, and you are adjusting to the situation, then you can always change it on the fly, but most of the time, this won't be necessary. 200 will show you almost everything that you need to know. Now, how do you use your new and improved map? Imagine that you are running around on the battlefield and that you see your next victim in the distance. You are making your way to the next flag and the other guy is in the middle of nowhere. There are no usable landmarks, no poles with strippers, no nothing. You have absolutely no clue how far away this guy is. All you know is that he is running from left to right and soon he will be out of your line of sight. You could equip your fancy trench periscope. I mean, a pro sniper like yourself would never leave home without one, right? Like there's nothing better to choose from. And you can use it to accurately tell the distance to your target, but don't even bother. I tried. It won't tell you anything. The only thing that you can do with that thing is to spot him, but this takes way too long. But you can still spot him the normal way. And doing so will put this nice little red marker on your minimap, and that we can use. It's the only thing we got. The edge of your minimap is 200 meters. Halfway between the middle of the map and the edge is 100, and guess how much a quarter will be. This is all you need. Just spot a guy, quickly look at your minimap, and you will have a pretty good idea of the distance to your enemy. You know which gun that you are using, so you can instantly tell if he is within your sweet spot or not. There is only one thing left to do. Do what you do best. One shot, one kill. Now, it won't tell you if he is at 152 meters or at 148. I'm sorry, but we don't have that kind of equipment in Battlefield 1. It's World War 1, remember? This is the next best thing if he is not shaking his ass around one of the poles. By the way guys, the YouTube likes and shares are very helpful to me. If you think that this video is worthy, would you mind taking a moment to like this video and to share it with all your buddies? This was Fog of Gaming, thanks for watching, and I will see you on the battlefield.